that core application building process is now easier.
How difficult is to integrate OpenAI with Zoho Creator?
The system will actually understand your requirement and give you a software that you can use.
What about creating the loose code? So you talked about optimizing existing code, but what about creating code?
Yes, that is possible as well.
Bharath, thank you very, very much for meeting me today and talk to me about Zoho Creator and low code and automations and AI. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself, your position with Creator?
Definitely. First of all, thank you so much, Lior. I know you had a long travel. You're here in India, Chennai, and still you're taking the energy to do this. Appreciate that a lot. A quick intro. I'm Bharath. I'm with Zoho for 6 years, around 18 years of total experience. Predominantly on the marketing customer experience side. At Zoho, I take care of the marketing user experience of the developer suite of products. Predominantly Creator, that's our flagship product in that space. In addition, I also work with the Flow team, the RPA, the Q Engine. These are the other products that I work with.
Fantastic. I want to ask you a big question. Everybody's talking about AI. How Zoho are preparing to work with AI, specifically with Zoho Creator?
Oh, that's a good start, an easy question to start with. At some point, even I personally felt, is AI hype? Is it really going to have an impact?
Right.
But now for sure, I can tell you that it is having an impact. Like you rightly asked, there is a Zoho level thought process. We have built our own LLMs. We are looking at training ourselves. We are empowering our users to use Zoho LLM itself.
What is LLM for people that don't know what it is?
Okay, so LLM is large language model. Predominantly, like if I have to simplify it, how much you can train the system, how many parameters that you can use to train a system to learn. What is AI actually doing? It is understanding past based on your training, then coming up with its own sort of intelligence to solve a future problem. So the more you train, the more parameters you feed, the better the quality of outcome from an AI will be.
Got
so
it.
Industry uses the system billion parameters. You will say 8 billion parameters, 11 billion parameters, etc. So that is an indication of how robust the system is. Now, companies have different options. There are organizations that work with someone like OpenAI, mm-hmm. where OpenAI provides the LLM framework. They have done the training. I copy that or I import that and use it inside my, let's say, my business application. Could be I'm running a CRM. I don't have the bandwidth to build my own LLM. I will work along with OpenAI and import those capabilities inside my CRM.
That's probably the most common approach.
Exactly, correct. But some organizations like Zoho, for example, we are doing a hybrid or we are doing both. The users have the choice of, hey, I already have an OpenAI subscription. So in addition to my Zoho application, let's say a CRM or a Creator, if I take Creator as an example, Creator provides application building through prompts. That's one use case through AI. You can just chat with the system and the system will build.
It's insane.
Yeah, thank you for that. So this works either through OpenAI, if you have an OpenAI subscription, OpenAI key, or you can do it through the Zoho LLM itself. So that's where Zoho is slightly different. We are also bringing our own LLM to the picture.
And one question, how difficult is to integrate OpenAI with Zoho Creator?
It is not difficult at all. So because we call it bring your own key, so you need to have a subscription and it's like a one-time connection that you establish. After that, it is just straightforward. The user may not even know that I need to do these steps for integration after he does it once. So that is straightforward.
So I will go to OpenAI, grab the key from the settings page, paste it, and it's
very
done.
Crudely put, yes, that's how it works. But why does this even matter is when you use OpenAI, you are paying for the subscription.
Right.
The number of calls that you make to OpenAI for your query, based on that, you will be charged. Currently, what Zoho is doing is that LLM charge, or very crudely put, that AI inquiry charge is a part of your Zoho subscription itself. So when you use Creator to build an app by prompting the system, you're not paying an additional cost for using these AI capabilities. It is as straightforward as what you pay for Zoho Creator, that's the same cost.
So with subscription fee, you will have the Zia AI,
exactly.
which is part of what Zia created in the past, you know, many years.
Correct.
And that's the same subscription.
Correct, exactly. So from a what are we doing in Creator, I think the initial question of, I would put it in two buckets, Lior. So first is, Creator is a low-code platform. Low-code platform, again, if for folks who may not be exposed to it, I have a 10-year-old son. So he asked me, what do you do at work? I tell him, he understands flowchart. So I tell him, assume you have a flowchart. there is a stop, there is a decision block, there are multiple steps, there is an end. Assume you create a flowchart and the backend code gets auto-generated, that is low code for you. I'm putting it in a very, very crude, simple way, like explaining to a 10-year-old, but that's what low-code platforms do. You drag and drop components and the code gets auto-generated, which is a very powerful use case. That is on one hand. Now there is AI. AI is making a lot of aspects of our life easier. Let's say you want to create some content, you want to write an email. Content is coming from AI. Code, if you throw a prompt to the system saying, I want lines of code for, let's say, calculating some days of leave. The system is actually understanding your requirement and giving you, hey, here's the 10 lines of code that you can copy paste. So that is a very powerful capability. Where this is becoming much exciting is when AI and low code come together. I can use AI to take lines of code. I can use AI to solve certain problems. But how do I actually use it? How do I deploy it? How do I ensure it is like secure, compliant, privacy focused, etc.? Those are the low code strengths. Because the platforms, when you use Zoho Creator, your focus is on business logic. You're not worried about how will I deploy it? How will I get a mobile app?
Servers and all the stuff that is being taken care for me.
Exactly. That is done by the platform. So all of that, we use the term abstraction. All of it is abstracted. The user need not know. Like, for example, for your business requirement, let's say you have a purchase request approval need in your organization. Your focus is on what is the workflow. One person is going to raise a request. It will go to person A for first level approval. If the value is greater than $1,000, let's say it goes to second person. They approve. It goes to the finance department, let's say. They approve. It goes to the vendor. He will supply the material, update in the system. The requester will know that the material is received.
So there is a flow.
Correct. This flow, for you to convert it as an application, if you are not using low code, there are 100 things that will come in your mind when you actually want to create a software. Like, where will I host it? How will it be secure? How will it work on mobile? How do I ensure it is in line with my organizational policies and constraints, etc.? All these are solved by low-code platforms. Let's say you use Zoho Creator for this specific purchase approval need. You're only building the application. Like, your focus is only on the business logic. Drag and drop components. Say that this is the first step, this is the second step, this is the flow, and you're done. You're not even doing a deployment step because that is taken care of by the platform. Security compliance is handled by the platform. When you build something on web, automatically a mobile app becomes available. So we call this abstraction, where there are those 100 things that are stopping you from becoming, let's say, someone who can build a software. All of those are handled by the platform. So that's what low code brings. Now, again, coming back to the original question, where it's becoming 100x more powerful is AI makes the building process easier. Low code makes the whole hosting consumption process easier. Now, when they two come together, it is not just AI plus low code, it is actually becoming AI into low code. So in Zoho Creator platform, if you want to build this purchase approval process application, you can do it without writing a single line of code in a matter of minutes.
Just so, by typing the prompt.
So the industry calls this prompt engineering. The more clear you can tell the system, this is what I want, the better the outcome will be. But it is as simple as how good you are in communication. It's not about the development skills or software skills. How clearly you can communicate to the system will actually understand your requirement and give you a software that you can use.
You know, when you were talking about the server side and, you know, taking care of the load and taking care of security and compliance, I'm not doing it for so many years because I'm with Zoho Creator.
Okay.
I totally forgot about load balancers and all the story behind it, which was a nightmare to deal with.
Exactly.
Wow, you brought me, you know, to disaster days many years ago.
Yeah, I think I can empathize with you because when there are questions around these aspects, I'm also thinking, when was the last time I did those things? Because I'm also using Zoho Creator, so I can definitely understand. Yeah.
Yeah, we have clients, you know, that's coming with healthcare. Sure, we're HIPAA compliant.
Mm.
But if you don't have Zoho Creator, can you be HIPAA compliant?
Mm.
It will cost you hundreds of thousands of dollars to get compliant.
Correct.
And then you need credit card, PCI compliant.
Exactly.
So those are hundreds of thousands of dollars that someone already taking care of it. And I already forgotten from all this complexity. So,
but other thing, Lior, what you're saying is a very, very important point. Because that core application building process is now easier. Everybody can build. Maybe you can use AI, you can use it along with low code. So as a platform vendor, what is my focus? make the process much more easier. How easily you can integrate with OpenAI? How can I provide Zoho LLM so you can build faster?
Right. Yes.
But what is going to become much more important is the other aspects that you mentioned now, in terms of, let's say, compliance, security, privacy. How do I ensure that load balancing, things like that, are taken care of by the platform very well? So the user knows that it is not just the application building process, the hosting, the consumption, everything becomes easier with low-code platforms. That's our focus as well.
So there is really building the top layer, which is the low-code.
Correct.
And all the rest is the same, like I would create it with low-code.
Correct. I think 90%, yes. What is happening with AI is now not just code development. Like you rightly said, it makes that process easier. But a lot of AI tools are actually now being used for requirement gathering. For example, let's say you and I are in the same organization. We are discussing about a business requirement. Typically, what will happen? We will record this over a meeting. Let's say we do it over a Zoho meeting or a Zoom meeting. We record that meeting. Or we can sit together, take a pen and paper and draft what we need. Or it can be some whiteboarding tool where we create a flowchart saying this is the step. Now, AI is making all these as inputs. We call it multimodal input. You just upload the recording. The system understands it and converts it to an application. You take a photo of the chart that you drew, upload it to the system, become an application. Let's say you built a solution for your business need. It's working fine. But let's say there are updates in the platform that makes the whole process. Let's say what you did with 10 lines of code is with a new update is now possible with 5 lines of code. Less compute space, less energy consumption and all that. The system will now tell you that, hey, what you're doing is serving your purpose. Your whole purchase process is still going to work fine, but I found another way to optimize performance. So it's not just writing lines of code. It's business requirement understanding, it's optimization. In all those areas, also AI is coming into the game. That's why I think it is not just 1 to 10x productivity, it is 1 to 100x productivity in a couple of years' time. That's what we are looking at.
So one of the things that I see AI coming in is to be the master of languages. Any language, English, Deluge, PHP, French, anything.
Yeah.
So I do see that developers will need to adjust to AI, the same as content writer adjusting to AI.
Correct.
Otherwise, they will have no place in the the food chain.
Correct.
But from what you're saying now, also business people that's supposed to optimize processes.
Correct.
They also need to be part of the process.
Correct.
That's huge.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Because there are not too many people that they have good business understanding. And if an AI can do it for you, that's huge.
But what we are seeing really in organizations also is, purely from a structure point of view, we are seeing more and more IT people not being in the IT team. What I mean by that is, let's say there is a product team, there is an operations team. The IT person is now becoming a part of those teams. So he is a part of the core ops team, building things that are needed for that business. Whereas there is a central IT team, IT department that manages compliance, purchase of software, maintenance and things like that. So the lines between, like you rightly said, business IT, that is blurring heavily, not just from a capability point of view, as straightforward as in the org structure itself, it is sort of merging heavily now.
Now, everything that you're saying, is that part of the roadmap of Zoho Creator for 2025, or that's, you know, many years from now?
Whatever examples that I told now, almost all of them are already there in the product, like prompting the system to build applications and things like that have been there for more than 4 or 5 months now. So making it more and more sharper, understanding the prompts better so that more relevant applications can be given. That is what we are working on. Not just, let's say, a form or a basic data structure, reports, dashboards, visualizations, mobile apps, all of that are also available already. The certain other things that I mentioned, let's say deluge optimization, understanding the code and optimizing the code. Those are things that we are rolling out as we speak. In the next couple of months, you will see those things. The multimodal input that I talked about, currently it works already for certain of the inputs. Like for example, uploading a flowchart is currently possible through Zoho Creator itself, but uploading a voice recording is currently not there. So that those are things that we are working on.
What about creating deluge code? So you talked about optimizing existing code, but what about creating code?
Yes, that is possible as well. Let's say you are inside the creator interface, or for that matter, any Zoho product that uses Deluge. In the Deluge interface, you can prompt the system again, saying, I need Deluge code for leave approval process. the system will actually give you code. You can just copy paste it.
It will generate the code for you.
Yes.
Wow.
Yep.
And that's already happening. That's already.
Yes.
Wow, that's huge.
Yeah.
So, where do you see everything, all that, in 5 years?
Ah, oh, that's a very interesting question. I think the categories will merge. There may not be low code as a category. There may not be.
So the low code will be eaten by the AI?
No, I'm saying functions will become more important. Business needs will become more important. It wouldn't matter whether you're using low code, pro code, PHP, whatever tool that you're using will become immaterial because that fundamental layer is going to come from AI. Whether you want code, the lines of code in option A, option B, option C will be given in a platter to you. So that will become immaterial. For your need, you choose A or B or C, makes it easier. Where the whole game will become much more powerful or like focuses, like it touched upon earlier, the compliance, security, those peripheral aspects. How well is your code maintained? How easy it is for you to give access to the right people, etc. Second, and the other important thing in my personal opinion is the domain knowledge. The fundamental principle of low-code platforms itself is respecting the uniqueness of an organization. Let's say there are hundreds and thousands of organizations in a space. Each one works differently on some parameter or other. It could be pricing, it could be people.
100%.
Now, is your software respecting that uniqueness? Are you using a software that is tailor-made for your business? Or are you using a standard software and force-fitting it for your needs? Which is where custom applications will be needed. Which is what a low-code platform like Creator provides.
Right.
Now, that will become much more important. Like, you could be a manufacturing organization. You could be a process manufacturing organization. You could be manufacturing something very unique. Like, we have customers who are, like, producing olive oil who are using Creator. So, the more and more empowerment happens in terms of the whole application building process, the more and more customized your application building process will become. So, it will be tailor-made for your requirement. It is not a standard off-the-shelf solution that multiple organizations will use. Because the whole building process is going to become easier, you can build things that will work specifically for your organization. What it means is, why I said the boundaries will merge, Lioris. So it is straightforward for low-code platform. How do we make it more and more customizable, easily consumable, etc. But what about a standard off-the-shelf software? Now, they will also be forced to think, I cannot act as a standard solution. I should become a platform. Let's say I am selling a finance solution or a CRM solution. Even those in 5 years' time will definitely become platforms. What you can pick from the vendor, you will pick. But the vendor also will offer capabilities to customize it as much as possible for your needs. So the whole game will become everybody is a platform. I think that's the direction that we are going at.
You know, it's very interesting what you're saying, because also today when we are selling verticals, which is a specific custom application, we always need to customize it for the client. There is no business that is taking the solution as is and they're happy with it.
Correct.
So, wow, that will be huge.
Correct.
If an AI can do all that.
Correct. So how do we make the customization easier? I think that will be the whole key.
Wow, that's huge. Look, you opened my brain to a million places.
Okay.
Thank you very much for sharing with me all your knowledge. Looking forward to see where all this AI will take us. Thank you very much for your time.
Definitely. I think partners like you are a huge support for us. So because there is only so much that we can explain, that we can go to market with what we have. Your local knowledge, your understanding of the domain, I think you play a huge part in our success. So thank you so much and we look forward to working with you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.